Welcome back all of you. So in today's lecture, we are going to continue the chapter industrialization as you can see in this slide. So in the previous topic, we basically discussed about the region of industrialization, impact of industrialization and how people's life affected, what kind of protest people did to survive in the industries. So everything we discussed. So in today's lecture, we are going to talk about a debate, and we are going to discuss about that was there an industrial revolution. Humne us time period ko frame out kar diya, that the period between the 15th to 18th century, or 16th to 18th century, or 18th to 20th century. I am just giving you different time frame, because industrialization previously began in the 15th century. So that period was quite long. So like, is it appropriate to define that time period, that this was a time period of industrialization or not? So we are just discussing the points for as well as against. So firstly, the term industrial revolution basically was used to describe the changes that occurred in the Britain between 1780 to 1820. So what they are saying, कि हम इस टाइम पीरियड को इंडस्ट्रियल रेवोल्यूशन कह सकते हैं कि नहीं कह सकते हैं. सो द टर्म अनदर थिंग बेसिकली चैलेंज्ड करती है ये मॉडर्न हिस्ट्रियंस को. इंडस्ट्रियलाइजेशन वॉज अ ग्रेजुअल चेंज इन इंडस्ट्रियल सेक्टर रादर देन अ सडन रेवोल्यूशन. सो सम जो हिस्ट्रियंस हैं, व्हाट दे सेड दैट इंडस्ट्रियल रेवोल्यूशन इज नॉट सडन. So, as I already told you, that it was a very long process. We cannot frame that revolution for a shorter span, because revolution cannot come within within the span of 50 years and 20 years. So basically, it took a quite long. So another thing we are going to discuss in the next state about the debate. So the concentration of worker in the factories, wide use of money. So now we are going to discuss the further points, the another points. So in this, what we are going to talk about, the concentration of worker in factories. So basically, because of the concentration of worker, there was wide use of money. So these things already existed prior to 19th century. So now we are going to talk about against. हम डिबेट में अगेंस्ट जा रहे हैं कि हम क्यों नहीं, मतलब इस टाइम पीरियड को इंडस्ट्रियल रेवोल्यूशन का टाइम पीरियड कहना चाहते. द रीज़न, फर्स्टली हम इसमें, इट्स अ वेरी गुड पॉइंट दे सेड, कि ये सारी चीज़ें तो प्रायर भी एग्जिस्ट करती थी. सो इंडस्ट्रियलाइजेशन कैरिड आउट द प्रोसेस टूवर्ड न्यू लेवल. हम ये कह सकते हैं कि विद इन दैट टाइम फ्रेम 1780 टू 1820 इंडस्ट्रियल रेवोल्यूशन अनदर लेवल पे गई है, एडवांस हुई है. बट वी कैनॉट से कि इंडस्ट्रियल रेवोल्यूशन यहाँ से बिगिन हुई है. इंडस्ट्रियल रेवोल्यूशन बहुत पहले स्टार्ट हो चुकी थी, अराउंड 15th and 16th century. लार्ज एरियाज ऑफ इंग्लैंड, अनदर वी आर गोइंग टू सेकेंड पॉइंट. लार्ज एरियाज ऑफ इंग्लैंड बेसिकली लेफ्ट अनअफेक्टेड बाई फैक्ट्रीज और माइंस, देयर फॉर द टर्म इंडस्ट्रियल रेवोल्यूशन वॉज कंसिडर्ड एज इनकरेक्ट. सो दिस इज अ सेकेंड पॉइंट विच वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस, दैट इट इज़ वेरी अनफेयर. Only like London, Birmingham and some places available in England developed. But there are many places which were considered remote and which were not developed in the time of Industrial Revolution. So how we can say that that was a revolution? So revolution means change. Change in every sphere, I can say. So, but there are some areas which were unaffected. So this is a second argument. Third one, that industrialization had concentrated on a few regions or cities. Another thing, as I already told you, London, Manchester, Birmingham or Newcastle. So we cannot say that this is a revolution. Yeah, we can say that this is a revolution in London, revolution in Manchester, revolution in Birmingham, but we cannot call that this was a revolution in all over England. Another debate we are going to discuss, could the growth of the cotton or iron industry or in the foreign trade from the 1780 to 1820 be called revolutionary? Second हमारा debate का topic है कि 1780 to 1820 में जो iron industry, cotton, foreign trade में growth हुई थी, can we call it as revolution? So now, again, we are going to talk about the arguments. Textile industry basically relied on non-British raw material. What does it mean? Non-British raw material. We already discussed that raw material the British gained, acquired from their colonies like India. India se cotton jati thi bahut zyada. And on sales of abroad, especially India. So, baad mein kapda bana ke bhi kahan bechte the? Indian markets mein, apni colonized market ke andar. So, basically, it's not, matlab, no, British ka itna control nahi tha uske upar. Metallic money and steam power was rare till the 19th century. Bahut zyada nahi thi. The rapid growth in British import and export from the 1780s occurred due to resumption of the trade with the North America. रैपिड ग्रोथ क्यों हुई थी ब्रिटेन के इम्पोर्ट में एक्सपोर्ट में? बिकॉज उनका जो ट्रेड था जो पहले ब्रिटेन सॉरी अमेरिका के साथ चलता था वो दोबारा से स्टार्ट हो गया था क्योंकि बीच में वो ट्रेड बंद हो गया था ड्यू टू द सिविल वॉर इन अमेरिका. अमेरिका में 1756 के टाइम पीरियड के करीब एक सिविल वॉर हुई थी. उस सिविल वॉर की वजह से ट्रेड जो थे बहुत ज़्यादा इंटरप्ट हुए थे जो इंग्लैंड के साथ ट्रेड था. बट लेटर ऑन दैट कंटिन्यू व्हेन द सिविल वॉर एंडेड. So the American War of Independence had disrupted this trade as I already told you. तो इस time period में मतलब कोई trade नहीं होता था इसी वजह से उन्होंने अपनी colony से चीज़ें acquire करनी start कर दी. So we cannot call it that Britain's industrial revolution because the whole world contributed in it. Another debate, sustained industrial growth was to be seen after. So ज़्यादा growth देखने को मिली है after 1850 to 1920. The French Revolution, Napoleonic Wars affected industries and factories decade after 1793. So all these kind of revolutions also affected. Industrialization is closely basically related with investment of capital, building of infrastructure, installing new machines, rising productivity. So however, productive investment grew steadily only after 1820. So we cannot say everything happened between that period. There are many things, many modern things, jinko modern cheeze kehte hain, investment, infrastructure, new machines, rising productivity, everything increased after 1820. So it means that time frame we cannot give. So another debate related with the cotton and iron and engineering industries that like they basically produced less than half of the industrial production until the 1840 तक वो बहुत ज़्यादा कम production करते थे. कोई ज़्यादा production नहीं थी that we can call that period industrial revolution. So another यहाँ पर question आता है why the British economic growth was faster after 1815. क्यों growth जो थी वो बहुत ज़्यादा faster हो गई थी? तो इसके पीछे reason था that historian pointed out that from 1760 to 1815 Britain tried to do two things simultaneously, to industrialize and to fight wars in the Europe. Meaning, England was engaged in two type activities. एक तो वो अपनी industries को develop कर रहा था, but at the same time उसका एक आधा ध्यान जो था वो कहाँ पर था? In the wars which he fought, which England fought with the rest of the Europe. So borrowed capital was used to fight the wars rather than invested. जो भी वो मतलब उनके पास पैसा आता था, capital आती थी, तो वो दो पार्ट्स में डिवाइड हो जाती थी. सो दैट्स वाई इंग्लैंड कैन नॉट कंसंट्रेट ओनली एंड ओनली ऑन इंडस्ट्री. एंड आफ्टर 1820 व्हेन दीज काइंड ऑफ वॉर्स एंडेड इंग्लैंड सोली कंसंट्रेटेड ऑन द इंडस्ट्रियलाइजेशन. सो दैट्स वाई दे सेड कि ग्रोथ उसके बाद ज़्यादा हुई थी. सो नियरली 35% ऑफ कॉस्ट ऑफ द वॉर वॉज कलेक्टेड फ्रॉम द पीपल्स टैक्स एज टैक्स. Workers of factories and farms were transferred to army because they need a huge army because England was engaged in the wars. Rise in food prices adversely affected the buying of consumer goods by the poor. Napoleon's policies of blockade and British response to them led to the closing of Europe to the British traders. Matlab they really didn't have a good relationship, the Europe and the England. सो इस वजह से भी हम उस पीरियड को नहीं कहते डिपेट. द वर्ड इंडस्ट्रियल यूज्ड विद द वर्ल्ड रेवोल्यूशन इज टू लिमिटेड. सो इस टाइम पीरियड को हम रेवोल्यूशन नहीं कह सकते. सो चेंजेस हैपन्ड इन टू ग्रुप्स. एक तो बोर्गोइस एंड द न्यू क्लास ऑफ वर्कर्स प्रोलेट्रेट. सो बेसिकली टू ग्रुप्स के अंदर चेंजेस हुए थे. एक बोर्गोइस, एक मतलब द न्यू क्लास ऑफ वर्कर्स. एक तो जो पुरानी क्लासेस अवेलेबल थी लाइक प्रीस्ट, लाइक नोबल, उनकी डेवलपमेंट हुई थी, बट एट द सेम टाइम द न्यू क्लास ऑफ वर्कर्स लाइक मिडिल क्लास दैट वॉज ओरिजिनेटेड वेन द इंडस्ट्रियल रेवोल्यूशन केम वेन द डेवलपमेंट इन इंडस्ट्रीज हैपन्ड. So another thing, debate the 1851, Britain basically arranged a great exhibition at specially constructed Crystal Palace in London to view the achievements of British industry. So like we are going to talk that how England dominantly say that that time period was industrial revolution. Ek to unhone exhibition ki thi Crystal Palace in London ke andar. Another thing, at the time half of the population was living in towns. But of the workers in the town, as many were in handicrafts unit as in factories. So basically, हम कहते हैं कि industrial revolution किसको कहते हैं? Like one, population is living in the towns. Another thing, that working in the factories. Another thing, you can see the things were changing in England. In the another topic, in the debate, from 1850, basically people, जो towns के अंदर रह रहे थे, so वो basically working class थी, because that town were very near to the industries, and only 20% of Britain's workforce now lived in rural areas. तो we are talking about the four. क्यों हम इसको industrial revolution कहते हैं? क्योंकि लोग towns के अंदर रहते थे, rather than the rural area. So this was far more rapid rate of industrialization that had been witnessed in other European countries. So बाकियों के comparatively Britain was like बहुत forward था उस time industrial revolution industrialization के अंदर. So in his detailed study of British industry, the historian A. E. Masson has suggested that there are good grounds for regarding the period 1850 to 1940 as that in which industrial revolution really occurred. तो मसन ने सजेस्ट किया था कि दैट टाइम पीरियड इज़ परफेक्ट फॉर इंडस्ट्रियल रेवोल्यूशन ऑन मैसिव स्केल ट्रांसफॉर्मिंग द होल इकोनॉमी एंड सोसाइटी मच मोर वाइडली एंड डीपली देन अर्लियर चेंजेस जो हम कहते हैं 1780 टू 1820s. इट मीन्स देर आर मेनी हिस्ट्रियंस हु टोल्ड दैट द टाइम पीरियड विच दे हैड टेकन वॉज नॉट अप्रोप्रिएट दे शुड टेक द टाइम पीरियड फ्रॉम 1850 टू 1914 क्योंकि उस टाइम पर बहुत ज़्यादा इंडस्ट्रियल रेवोल्यूशन हुई थी. सो विद दिस our chapter is complete. I hope all topic is very clear to you. Thank you and have a wonderful day.